Today, I'm going to answer the question, why don't we need the absolute value when we do trig sub for an integral? And this is what I mean. Let's say we want to simplify square root of x squared. When we cancel the square root and the square, we don't just get x, because x could be negative. To prevent the output of the square root from being negative, we will have to put absolute value around the x. But if we're trying to simplify square root of cosine square theta, for example, because this is a trig sub expression, it seems that we can just cancel the square root and the square and get cosine theta. But cosine could be negative sometimes, right? So why don't we put the absolute value? And that's the question. Firstly, though, let's take a look at the integral that will give us that situation. The integral of square root of 1 minus x squared. Do a trig sub, let x equal to sine theta, because 1 minus sine square theta gives us cosine square theta. Let's also get the dx, which is cosine theta d theta. Now take this integral to the theta world. We have the integral of the square root, 1 minus sine square theta, and then the dx is cosine theta d theta. Now for the inside of the square root, this gives us cosine square theta, and then we have the cosine theta d theta from the outside. This is the part that we were talking about earlier. When we cancel the square root and the square, it seems like everybody just puts down cosine theta. Nobody puts down the absolute value, huh? So why is that? I'm going to leave the answer for the integral to you guys, because I would like to answer why don't we need the absolute value. Here's the deal. If you look at this expression, let's say we just want to stick with the real numbers, then we will have to make sure inside of the square root is non-negative. So we will have a condition, 1 minus x squared is greater than or equal to 0. Well, to find out for all the x values that will make this true, let's look at the equation y equals 1 minus x squared and the graph of that, which is just an upside down parabola, will look something like this. And the x-intercepts will be at negative 1 and 1. And we want this to be greater than or equal to 0, so it's above the x-axis and also on the x-axis. So in order for this inequality to be true, x will have to be in between of negative 1 and 1. And this is perfect for the sine function, because earlier we said x is equal to sine theta, and sine is in between of negative 1 and 1. It's true for all theta values though. However, if we're doing a substitution for an integral, we will have to make sure the substitution, that function, is 1 to 1 on the interval that we are considering. So what we mean by that is the following. Let's take a look at the sine graph. So this is like this and like that. So this right here is actually very similar to how we have to restrict the domain for sine function in order to get the inverse. This is not 1 to 1 because if you just draw a horizontal line, you can see that the horizontal line passes the curve more than one time. So to restrict the domain, I will just go from here to here. Then that is going to be 1 to 1 because it passes the horizontal line test on that interval. And that will give us from negative pi over 2 up to positive pi over 2. So we are going to impose the condition that theta has to be in between of negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2, including the endpoints. Now, earlier we were talking about square root of cosine square theta being equal to just cosine theta. Well, the deal is that this is greater than or equal to 0 for theta in between of negative pi over 2 and positive pi over 2. And this is why we don't need the absolute value for cosine theta. And just take a look at the graph of cosine theta real quick though. It looks like this. So from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2, cosine is non-negative. That's the reason why we don't need the absolute value. And same situation applies for other substitution as well. We just had to restrict the theta value in order to make sense of why we don't need the absolute value. And let me just give you guys a summary for all that. This is the one that we were talking about earlier. So square root of cosine square theta. This is cosine theta. This is greater than or equal to 0 if you just restrict it to theta in between of negative pi over 2 and positive pi over 2. On this interval, you just have to make sure the output is non-negative. In the meantime, you should also make sure that the substitution, in this case, the sine function is 1 to 1. The output does not have to be 1 to 1. This right here is not 1 to 1, but this right here has to be 1 to 1. So, the next one, let's talk about the secant substitution, and that's the case when we have, you know, some square minus 1. In that case, use secant square theta. And by the way, nobody really uses cosecant or cotangent substitutions because they have negative derivatives. That's why we just stick with sine, secant, and tangent substitutions. This right here, for the inside, we get tangent square theta, and to get just tangent theta, to make this non-negative, we are going to restrict the domain theta to be in between of 0 and pi over 2. But both tangent and secant cannot take when theta is equal to pi over 2. So there's no equal sign for that. The reason that I said this is a little trickier is because if you look at this part right here, we will have to ensure either secant theta is greater than 1 or secant theta is less than negative 1. When secant theta is greater than 1, then there's no problem that tangent will be non-negative on this interval. And also on this interval, secant is 1 to 1. However, when you have secant theta is less than negative 1, that is just kind of annoying. I would say if you really run into this kind of situation where you do an integral, here's the deal. If you have to do the integral of square root of x squared minus 1, if x is negative, let's say we are going from negative 3 to negative 2. Just do a substitution. This right here is equal to the integral from 2 to 3. It's the same thing. And the reason is because if you look at the square root of x squared minus 1 graph, it looks like this. So if you go from negative 3 to negative 2, this, it's the same as if you go from 2 to 3. So that can really just stick with x being positive. That will be much better. Lastly, let's talk about the tangent substitution. That's the case when we have tangent square theta plus 1, or maybe 1 plus tangent square theta because the order of addition doesn't matter. For the inside, we get secant square theta, and to get just secant theta without the absolute value, to ensure this is non-negative, we will have to make sure theta is in between of negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. On this interval, tangent is 1 to 1, and secant, it's not 1 to 1, but it will be positive. And in fact, secant cannot equal to 0, so technically, I will just take out that equal sign. Doesn't really matter that much though. Yeah. So, that's it.